The last time humans were on the moon was 1972. Since then, it's been 50 years and we haven't left Earth's orbit, but not for long. NASA's plans for their Artemis program plans to change all of that and send humans back to the moon, and this time for building a settlement. The Artemis program will prepare humanity for the next giant leap, the exploration of Mars. But how does the Artemis program plan to take humans to the moon? Why will it be important? What will the Artemis program consist of? In this video, we will talk about that and more. Back to our future on the moon now. Do you ever get the feeling of being followed online? We present to you Private Internet Access VPN, number one choice for security. PIA provides the most transparent VPN online. It changes your IP address and channels your traffic through an encrypted tunnel, making you fully anonymous. Private Internet Access hides your IP address and encrypts your internet connection, keeping you safe online. While this does wonders for your digital security, it also gives you a chance to watch more content than ever before. For example, just connect to a server in the UK and you'll be able to watch the latest season of Peaky Blinders on BBC iPlayer. Handy, right? PIA VPN is available for all platforms: Windows, macOS, Android, Linux, iOS, and many more. Their payment methods include credit cards, PayPal, gift cards, and cryptocurrencies. We have an insane offer for our insane curiosity viewers. Sign up now to get an increased digital privacy for less than $2 a month by clicking on the link. 4 extra months for free, meaning only $1.98 a month, a discount of 83% off, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, 24/7 customer support. Make your VPN experience truly your own. The last time humans were on the moon was in 1972, when the last Apollo mission, Apollo 17, returned back after 12 days. Even though we never went back to the moon, for the last 20 years, humans have continuously stayed and worked at the International Space Station, preparing for the day when we venture back into deep space. NASA's Artemis program plans to do just that. It's not just humans going to the moon, it's humanity going back to the moon, and this time for a permanent stay. Sending astronauts 250,000 miles to the moon and then 140 million miles to Mars requires a bold vision, effective technology, good funding, an excellent program management, and support from countries and partners all around the world. NASA has been working tirelessly on the Artemis plan to achieve this bold plan ever since President Trump called on the agency to return humanity back to the moon and beyond. The first clear reference to a lunar mandate came in Trump's Space Policy Directive on December 1, 2017, which instructed NASA to focus on lunar missions. Then in March of 2019, Vice President Mike Pence, citing a space race with Russia and China, set NASA an ambitious deadline to have humans land near the South Pole of the Moon by 2024, at least 4 years ahead of schedule by the agency at the time. The 2024 closing date became met with a few complaints and issues nearly immediately, with questions bobbing up from inside NASA, Congress, and different establishments approximately how the organization might put together new factors, inclusive of a rocket, a spacesuit, and a human landing system, appropriately in time. With its current Artemis program, NASA plans to send astronauts to the South Pole by 2024 and ultimately establish a permanent presence on the moon. In the Artemis program, the first woman and the first person of color will land on the moon, along with the first international astronauts to participate on the moon. The infrastructure for the program is huge, from an outpost on a space station to spacesuits, and from takeoff and landing equipment to commercial payloads. The Artemis program is run primarily by NASA and American commercial space companies in collaboration with the European Space Agency and the space agencies of several other nations. Other countries have been invited to join the program by signing the current Artemis Agreement, which is open for signature since October 2020. NASA's mission plan is twofold. It focuses on achieving the goal of human landing by 2024 with acceptable technical risks, while at the same time working towards sustainable lunar exploration in the mid to late 2020s. 2024 will be the most ambitious date possible, and the fate of NASA at landings on the moon and later on Mars will be determined by the first initial landing of the Artemis mission. The United States is unchallenged in space exploration today. However, as more countries and companies take aim at the moon, America needs the earliest possible landing on the moon, as well as prepare for a historic first human landing to Mars. Landing astronauts on the moon by 2024 is an ambitious goal and requires state-of-the-art engineering, technology development, and process improvements to safely and successfully carry out sustained human exploration of the moon. It also opens the door to the U.S. commercial companies and international partners of NASA to the exploration and development of the moon. We need several years in orbit and beyond the moon to build the confidence of working to carry out long-term work and support life away from Earth before we embark on our first multi-year human mission to Mars. The sooner we get to the moon, the faster we land American astronauts on Mars. NASA plans to take immediate actions to make this vision a reality. And with the arrival of astronauts on the moon in 2024, it's a key to an effective test of the moon to Mars. NASA's next arrival of the moon opens the way for a new and more stable economy, when U.S. companies and its international partners will benefit there. The Artemis program is designed to land humans on the moon quickly, by 2024, and then focus on Mars as a long-term mission. The moon will be a good base if we plan to travel and live on Mars. Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, often says that we should have had a moon base by now. The moon will be our first experience on living and carrying out experiments on a celestial body outside of Earth. The short-term preliminary plan is to use both commercial rockets, such as NASA's Space Launch System, the Orion crew capsule, and a lunar landing system. A small space station in lunar orbit called the Gateway would serve for future surface missions. But how will these different systems work and coordinate to make the Artemis vision of landing humans safely back to the moon a reality? With the powerful Space Launch System, SLS rocket, and the Orion spacecraft ready and sitting on Launch Pad 39B at Kennedy Space Center, the agency has laid the foundation required to send humans back to the lunar orbit. The most powerful rocket ever built by NASA was rolled out to the launch pad on Thursday evening of March 17th. The rollout marks the culmination of a new NASA rocket that will help astronauts move to the moon, where they will be transferred to the SpaceX Starship Moon Lander, so that humans can return to the moon later in the decade. Orion and SLS are also the vehicles for the launch NASA's crew of missions at the upcoming Lunar Gateway Station. NASA's Space Launch System is NASA's heavy-lift rocket designed to carry people and cargo into the solar system. It's a massive rocket based on space shuttle-based technology. It's essentially a larger version of the shuttle stack that swaps the winged orbiter for cargo or for the Orion crew capsule on top. The center stage of the vehicle is a stretched external shuttle fuel tank, which is powered by four space shuttle main engines, RS-25s. During the shuttle program, these engines were refurbished and reused. For SLS, they will be ditched in the ocean. A pair of solid fuel rockets from the five-segment space shuttle are used to support the core phase in the initial phase of flight. The Orion spacecraft is a crew vehicle that can support up to four astronauts on space travel. Similar in concept, but with a larger interior space than Apollo capsules. Unlike capsules, which were designed solely for low Earth orbit transport, Orion's heat shield can withstand the high-speed re-entry required when returning from space. The Orion spacecraft consists of three main components: a pressurized crew capsule, a service module, and a launch abort tower that is nominally dropped on the rise. Orion has successfully completed one flight test to date, a high-Earth orbit mission called Exploration Flight Test 1, or EFT-1, on December 5, 2014. To make the lunar landing the safest, NASA seeks to make full use of early Artemis missions through additional testing of Orion and the Human Landing System, HLS. On top of this, the Lunar Gateway is a critical component for the Artemis mission. NASA will integrate the first two modules of the Gateway on Earth, launching the Power and Propulsion Element, PPE, and the Habitation and Logistics Output, HALO, together in 2023 on a single rocket, followed by a commercial logistics supply launch. In 2024, the Orion spacecraft will deliver its first crew to lunar orbit. After that, the commercially developed lander will take the crew to the lunar surface, which will be capable of docking directly to Orion for crew transfer for the early Artemis missions. But NASA will maintain flexibility for optional docking to the Gateway. On the surface of the moon, the crew will wear the new Exploration Extravehicular Mobility Unit, or XEMU spacesuit, which are next-gen high-tech spacesuits developed by NASA for the crew to explore the lunar surface and then Mars in the coming future. NASA unveiled two prototype spacesuits for Artemis in 2019. The first is the Exploration Extravehicular Mobility Unit, XEMU, a red, white, and blue suit designed to be worn on expeditions to the lunar surface. The second is the Orion Crew Survival System, a bright orange pressure suit worn by astronauts in the Orion capsule when they launch into space and return to Earth. Starting in October 2020, NASA planned to produce five XEMU suits in the first batch, one for design review, one for qualification testing, one for International Space Station in-orbit testing, and two for the first landing mission. In the future Artemis missions, the crew will arrive at the lunar gateway aboard Orion. On the gateway, they will be able to conduct research and take trips down to the surface of the moon. NASA will be working with Artemis providers to ensure that the spacecraft are built to international safety standards with as many reusable components as possible to make the program sustainable in the long term. NASA's international partners at the ISS are excited and ready to join NASA in lunar orbit. The Canadian Space Agency will provide the advanced robotics for the gateway, and the European Space Agency will provide the International Habitat, IHAB, and Esprit module, which will deliver additional communications capabilities, a science airlock for deploying science payloads and CubeSats and refueling of the gateway. The Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, or JAXA, will provide habitation components and logistics resupply. The Russian Space Agency, or Roscosmos, has expressed its interest in cooperation on the gateway as well. At the lunar South Pole, NASA, along with the help from its partners, will develop the Artemis base camp to support longer expeditions on the moon. In 2020, NASA revealed initial plans for its Artemis base camp near Shackleton Crater. As the facility evolves and grows, supplies of water, garbage disposal, communications, landing vehicles, and protection of astronauts from radiation will be needed, NASA said. The base will also include two mobility systems, a lunar all-terrain vehicle for the movement of astronauts on the surface, and a habitable mobility platform that could support trips from the base for up to 45 days. The facility can also allow for moon dust-related experiments, in-situ resource utilization of a far-side radio telescope. The elements of planned base camp include a lunar terrain vehicle, LTV or non-compressed rover, a portable platform, pressurized rover, a base module, power systems, and in-situ utility systems. This increase in the ability of the moon and its surroundings is crucial in establishing long-term exploration of the Earth's closest neighbor and in preparing for human exploration of Mars. The Artemis mission will be one of the most ambitious missions for NASA over the next few decades. The stakes can never get higher. NASA has to not only land humans back to the moon by 2024, but also make it sustainable in the long term. So what do you think about the Artemis plans we talked about in the video? Do you think we will be able to get boots on the moon by 2024? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section. In this video, we talked about the basic plans for the Artemis mission, but there will be many more updates coming in the near future. The SLS is already sitting on the launch pad. So if you don't want to miss out on the upcoming updates of the Artemis mission, make sure you subscribe to our channel and press that bell notification.